Hello friends, welcome to the Viva Voice of Anatomy. Today we will see the revision of a lower limb. Okay, the first things you should keep in the mind that in the exam you have to identify the side of the lower limb. In the exam sometimes you will be given the only the one limb, so you have to identify the whether it is the right or the left limb. Okay, so that you can identify from the great toe. Great toe is facing medially, right, and the little finger laterally, and this foot is facing towards the anteriorly, and by that way you can easily identify the site of a lower limb. Then you have to confirm the compartment of each region, for example the front of the thigh, medial side of the thigh, the lateral side of the thigh, back of the thigh, front of leg, back of leg, etc. Right, then and then you can able to identify the correct muscles. Now first we will start with the front of the thigh. In the front of the thigh, the important triangle that you see is a femoral triangle, right? So the boundary of the femoral triangle, the lateral boundary is by the medial border of the sartorius, and the medial border is also the medial border of the adductor longus. Now its floor is formed by, from lateral to medial, iliacus, psoas major, pectineus and adductor longus itself. The content of a femoral triangle, from medial to lateral, these are femoral vein, femoral artery, femoral nerve. Okay, now the muscle of a front of a thigh, they are the quadriceps femoris muscle. Out of this four muscle, the first muscle is the rectus femoris. It is a straight muscle, that's why this game its name is given rectus, rectus femoris. Okay, now below the rectus femoris you can see this muscle is a vastus intermedius, medially vastus medialis, and the laterally you will have the vastus lateralis muscle, this one. Okay, and also the sartorius muscle that will form the boundary of femoral triangle, and the one more muscle that lies in the deep, and it is very smaller muscle, that is articularis genu. Right, now you have to remember the nerve supply of the all the muscle. The nerve of the main nerve of the front of the thigh is the femoral nerve, so all the muscle will supplied by the femoral nerve. Additionally, the pectineus muscle is also supplied by the obturator nerve. So the pectineus muscle, remember, it is a hybrid muscle. The next muscle on the lateral side of the thigh, this one you can see tensor fasciae latae, that is inserted into the iliotibial tract, this white structure. Okay, the nerve supply of the tensor fasciae latae is a superior gluteal nerve. Okay, now we see the muscle of the medial compartment, that is known as the adductor compartment. Now the muscle of the adductor compartment are first the pectineus that we have seen in the front of the thigh, pectineus. The adductor longus also seen in the front of the thigh. The remaining muscle, the most medial, the slender muscle is a gracilis. Okay, now below the adductor longus you can see one more muscle, that is adductor brevis, and below it there is a large muscle, that is adductor magnus. Right, these are the muscle of the medial side of the thigh. All the muscle are supplied by the obturator nerve, whether anterior or the posterior division. And the pectin is additionally supplied by the femoral nerve, and adductor magnus is additionally supplied by the tibial part of the sciatic nerve. So these two are the hybrid muscles. Now we see the gluteal region. The first bulky muscle of the gluteal region, superficial one, that is the gluteus maximus, supplied by the inferior gluteal nerve. In the upper part, below the gluteus maximus, one more bulky muscle, that is the gluteus medius, supplied by the superior gluteal nerve. And below it, the small muscle, this white fibrous structure, it is a gluteus minimus, supplied by the superior gluteal nerve. Right, now below this gluteus medius you can see one more muscle, this one is a piriformis. Right, the piriformis muscle is a key muscle of a gluteal region, because the important structure passing along the its upper border as well as from the lower border. The structure which passes above the upper border are superior gluteal nerves and the vessels. Now the structure passing below the lower border are the posterior cutaneous nerve of thigh, the sciatic nerve, inferior gluteal nerve and vessels, nerve to quadratus femoris, pudendal nerve, internal pudendal vessels, and nerve to obturator internus. Right? Here you can see the sciatic nerve, the thickest nerve in the body. And the deep to the sciatic nerve, here you can see the three muscles, superior gemelli, obturator internus tendon, inferior gemelli. Right? Now the superior gemellus is supplied by nerve to obturator internus. The obturator internus is also supplied by the nerve to obturator internus. Inferior gemelli is supplied by the nerve to quadratus femoris. Now the below the inferior gemelli, you will have the quadratus femoris muscle, quadriangular muscle, that is supplied by nerve to quadratus femoris muscle. Now we see the back of the thigh. The muscle of the back of the thigh are known as hamstring muscle. These are the first we see the name of the hamstring muscle, that are semitendinosus, semimembranosus, long head of biceps femoris, and the hamstring part of a adductor magnus. Now we identify the structures. The first on the medial compartment, on the back of the thigh, the superficial muscle is a semitendinosus. It is having the long tendon, semitendinosus. Below it, you will have semimembranosus. Laterally, fused with the semitendinosus, you will have the long head of a bicep femoris, and below here, this is a short head of a bicep femoris. Okay. Now, in the deep, in the floor of the back of the thigh, you can see the largest muscle, that is the adductor magnus. Okay. So, all the muscle of the back of the thigh are supplied by the tibial part of a sciatic nerve. Adductor magnus again additionally supplied by the obturator nerve, which is a hamstring muscle. Now we see the back of the knee joint. In the back of the knee joint, you can see the diamond shaped fossa, that is known as a popliteal fossa. The boundary of the popliteal fossa, superomedially semitendinosus, semimembranosus, supplemented by the gracilis, sartorius, and adductor magnus. Superolaterally, it is formed by the biceps femoris muscle. Inferomedially, medial head of a gastrocnemius. Inferolaterally, the lateral head of gastrocnemius, which is supplemented by the small plantaris muscle. Now, the content of the popliteal fossa, the main content are the popliteal artery, the popliteal vein, and the nerve is the terminal part of a sciatic nerve, that is the tibial nerve, which is going vertically in the popliteal fossa, and the common peroneal nerve, which will run along the lower border of a biceps femoris towards the lateral. Now we will see the back of the limb. The back of the limb will contain the three superficial muscle and the four deep muscle. We first see the superficial muscle. The first muscle is the gastrocnemius. Here it is having the two head. Deep to the lateral head of a gastrocnemius, there is a small muscle which is having the small belly and the long tendon. This is the plantaris. Okay. And deep to the gastrocnemius, you will have the soleus muscle. Now the tendon of the gastrocnemius and the soleus, they will combine to form the common tendon, that is known as a tendocalcaneus. Now the muscle of the back of the leg are, yes. So at the ankle joint, you can trace this muscle from medial to lateral side. The first is a tibial is posterior muscle, then the flexor digitorum longus, and then the flexor hallucis longus muscle. The main vessel of the posterior compartment of the leg is a posterior tibial artery, and the main nerve is a tibial nerve. All the muscle of the back of the leg is supplied by tibial nerve. Now we see the lateral or the peroneal compartment of a leg. It contains only two muscles, that is, the superficial one is a peroneus longus and the deep one is a peroneus brevis. These two muscles are supplied by the superficial peroneal nerve, that is a terminal branch of a common peroneal. Now we see the front of a leg and the dorsum of the foot. First, the muscle of the front of the leg. Okay, so you can identify this muscle at the region of the ankle joint. from medial to lateral, these are tibialis anterior muscle, extensor hallucis longus muscle, extensor digitorum longus, and the most laterally, the peroneus tercius muscle. This one. All the muscle of the front of the leg is supplied by the deep peroneal nerve. That is a branch of a common peroneal nerve that you can see over here. This one is a deep peroneal nerve. And the medial to the deep peroneal nerve, that is a main blood supply of the front of a leg, that is a anterior tibial artery. Anterior tibial artery, the terminal branch of a popliteal artery. Now, the muscle of the dorsum of the foot, below the tendon of a extensor digitorum longus, you can see one small muscle having the four tendon, 1, 2, 3 and the four. This is extensor digitorum brevis. Now remember, the first tendon which is going into the thumb of a extensor digitorum brevis is known as a extensor hallucis brevis, right? Now the main artery of the dorsum of the foot is a dorsalis pedis artery, and it is a continuation of an anterior tibial artery that is dips down at a first intermetatarsal space towards the plantar surface. And the main nerve, of course, is a deep peroneal nerve. Okay. So this is about the front of leg. Now we see the sole of the foot. The most superficial structure, important structure in the sole of the foot, here you can see, is a plantar aponeurosis. After reflecting the plantar aponeurosis, you can see three muscles. That is the muscle of the first layer of the sole. Medially, this muscle is an abductor hallucis. The laterally, same way, the abductor digiti minimi. And the middle, you can see the muscle having the four tendon. That is a flexor digitorum brevis muscle. Now we see the muscle of the second layer of the sole, for which we have to cut this muscle, the flexor digitorum brevis muscle, right? Immediate below the tendon of flexor digitorum brevis, you can see the four tendon, this one, 1, 2, 3 and the four. This is a flexor digitorum longus muscle, the first muscle. The second muscle which get inserted into it is a flexor digitorum accessorius muscle, right? The third muscle that will take origin from its tendon. Here you can see the small muscle. These are this one, and this one. These are the four lumbricals. Takes origin from the tendon of flexor digitorum longus. And the fourth tendon, fourth muscle of the second layer, this one, which is going into the thumb, great toe, that is flexor hallucis longus. These four muscles are the muscle of the second layer of the sole. Now here you can see between the first and the second layer, the initial course of the medial and lateral plantar nerve along with the artery can pass. Here you can see the medially, this is the medial plantar nerve, the laterally, the lateral plantar nerve. Okay, the lateral plantar nerve later on will go deeply between the third and the fourth layer of the sole.
So the muscles of third layer are the flexor hallucis brevis, then adductor hallucis, and the flexor digiti minimi brevis. So muscles of the fourth layer are the tibialis posterior, peroneus longus, four dorsal introsei, three plantar introsei. So this is all about the revision of lower limb. Thank you.
If you like this video, like it and share with your friends. And to get the regular update on the anatomy videos, please subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon.